Anyway, Sergeant Mahari, my mother saved me from that window when I was 8. She took me back in, which meant Harry fell to get rid of me. So for the next several years, I'll continue to follow in Harry's footsteps. I'm attending the same nursery, the same primary school, and the same secondary school. Which basically meant I spent my school years getting in trouble for something that Harry had already done. Because they previously taught Harry, or they met Harry, and because we met, we looked very alike. Yeah. It's safe to say that Miss Skeleton, rest in peace, never liked me. No, she didn't like me. Although being at school with Harry wasn't all bad, there was actually a time when I was much smaller than him, and I had him to look out for me. I have one vivid memory, it must have been from primary school. I was yet to make any friends, but Harry was there, and I remember he came and sat with me, and he spent his break time with me playing with the hula. Now, I think that's the beauty of having a brother. Regardless of what happens in your life, you always have to make sure you're okay. So thank you, Harry, for being my brother. If you spend your marriage looking out for Clem, if you looked out for me, then you won't go far wrong. Now, more about you two. Harry and Claire met in Kew Club Reading. Yeah! For those of you that don't know it, take a second to imagine a romantic, but bit by kind of like scenic venue. Now, I'm joking, it's a joke. But regardless of that, it will always be the place that you two met. I'd love to be here today. Now, I have no idea what drew her to Harry and Matthew for that evening, as most of us have seen him after a few drinks. In fact, I remember a time Harry came home drunk. It was the first time that he'd ever come home drunk, and I was so worried about him, I spent the night sleeping in my sleeping bag outside. So, Harry, I have my sleeping bag in his room. He hasn't got any better from his drink. He sent me a video recently that Claire had recorded. I think it was 2 minutes and 32 seconds long, and it was a woman trying to take off his socks. So I know he joked about having a run, but maybe only by 1 or 2. There was also a time that he woke up in the middle of the night and mistook television and the toilet, which is a very awkward play on Mum and Dad's house in Europe. I have no idea where he got that from. No idea. I imagine it was actually out of his good books that draw Claire to Harry that night. Recently, he looked a lot more like me that day. Or it could have actually been down to his ability to stand out in the crowd. Make friends with absolutely anyone. Growing up with Harry, he was always the confident one between us. I remember on holiday, he'd always go up to everyone and he would say, "Who's your name? Who's your name?" And he'd repeat that. So maybe that's actually how he talked about that night. But whatever he'd done, it clearly worked. Now, since that night at Newcastle, you've come a long way. 3,133 days to be exact. You've done a lot in that time together. You've bought a home. You've both succeeded in your jobs. However, I think the main thing you've done is raise your marketing money. So I want to do something special.
He's not here.
He's not here. However, that's what I have to do. There's no way that Harley's well-behaved enough to be allowed, let alone an actual aerosol. Yes, take the prize position somewhere at the table.
Oh, okay.
whenever you're at home.
I want to thank you both for bringing us here together and so we finally love one another.
Now, what defines love? Good old Google suggests that love is defined by an intense feeling of deep affection. Now, from the outside looking in, it's clear since they have had more beautiful friends in our life that there has been a pure love between you two. Now, maybe not as much love as you both have for the money, but nonetheless, true love. I wish you both a lifetime of that love and may it never fade.
I would just like to take a quick moment to read a small message that Manning wrote at Ben. It could have been here today. First of all, we'd like to say congratulations to Harry and Claire. We regret not being able to be with you today on this special occasion. Harry is the first of our nine grandchildren and the first to get